knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
Next up in our survey of name reactions is the Favorskii rearrangement, not to be confused with the Favorskii reaction, which is actually something completely different. As applied to ring systems, it is a classical reaction inducing ring contraction, meaning that a ring is getting smaller. The reaction was invented by Russian chemist Alexei Favorskii in 1894. It applies to enolizable alpha-chloroketones, including acyclic substrates, but it is used in synthesis mainly as a ring contraction tool. Let's take a look at how this works now. To begin, we see formation of an enolate at the carbon opposite the halogen. Then the nucleophilic carbon from the enolate attacks the carbon that bears the chloro group, thus producing the very strained cyclopropanone intermediate. This is immediately attacked by the hydroxide base at the carbonyl carbon, and when these electrons come back down to reform the carbonyl, the new three-membered ring pops open, and the electrons in this bond remain with this carbon. This leaves a carboxylic acid with a carbanion moiety next door. Rapid proton transfer from the carboxyl group to the carbanion gives the following product. A key element of regiochemistry we must understand is that in a case such as this, when the system is not symmetrical, opening of the ring usually occurs to yield the less substituted and therefore more stable carbanion. This mechanism is consistent with the fact that isomeric alpha halo ketones yield the same carboxylate, such as here, where the structural difference between these two starting materials doesn't matter, because enolate attack onto the bromide gives the same cyclopropanone in both cases, although it is too strained and unstable to be isolated. This scheme illustrates two other facts. First, the reaction works for alpha-bromo ketones as well as chloroketones, although generally in lower yield. And second, when anhydrous alkoxides are used as bases, esters are obtained instead of the carboxylate salt. An elegant way to confirm that a symmetrical intermediate is formed is shown in the following scheme. As we can see, alpha-chlorocyclohexanone was labeled at the C1 bearing position with a 14C label. Favorskii rearrangement gave the cyclopentane carboxylate, in which the label was then found equally distributed in the alpha and beta positions, confirming the intermediacy of the cyclopropanone, which can be opened both ways with equal probability. Applications for this chemistry in synthesis are plentiful, especially when a larger ring size is easy to make, and ring contraction leads to rather strained systems. In Eaton's famous synthesis of the very strained cubane, the final cube structure was established with a Favorskii ring contraction. The last step was a simple thermal decarboxylation, which yielded the target cubic structure. Another ring contraction was applied to the lab synthesis of the poisonous alkaloid epibatidine found in frogs. This time, we start from another natural product, the protected tropanone we see here. This is alpha-brominated to yield a mixture of exo- and endo-alpha-bromides. Ring contraction using methoxide yields the desired 2-2-1 skeleton from the 3-2-1 precursor. Rather standard chemistry then converts the ester to the desired target, epibatidine, as a racemate. With many ring contraction strategies as applications, the Favorskii rearrangement continues to be a useful tool in the synthesis of natural products and other structures of interest.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.